Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to another video. This time, I'd like to talk about a ridiculous and very attention-seeking comment that popular YouTuber named Parlo, or Gaming Parlo as he's called, had made on Twitter. He had made a convincing-ish story on how he was going to kill himself, that he was self-harming, and that had gore and abuse, and I will show you it right now. This is what he said. I am done. With many things in general at this point, this is a combination of real life situations and online. I've reached a breaking point. For the past 2 days, I've been spending hours out of anger, slitting my wrists and entire arm with a compass and razor blades until it either bled, got infected, or reached a deeper fat layer of my arm. My arm is completely ruined. It burns, it bleeds, it hurts, it is full of cuts and torn skin. I've been starving myself of anything to eat and barely going to sleep. I've gotten physically ill. It's the anxiety, paranoia, relentless stress, and conflict I've found myself in for months too. No one can truly understand unless they've been a victim to it too. I've only told those who I trust that I was highly contemplating suicide again, as I did with the situation regarding my father where I tried to strangle myself with a belt, but it would be ill of me not to be honest with those who wish to know the truth. I have held the mentality that this community, the RTC, is one of the shittiest communities. Pure amount of internet degeneracy, herd mentality, and toxicity are rampant. A breeding ground of pessimism, conflict, and aggression. I can confirm because I used to participate in it. The number of users claiming I fake everything, the suicide attempt a few months ago, my domestic abuse and depression is unnaturally high. Do you know how worthless that makes me feel? Going through horrible shit, informing people about it, only to have the people claim I did it all for attention, trying to smear my reputation further down the mud. I never understood the hate Twitter received, but now I know all too well. It is a hellhole. I cannot effing take it, and this is me being honest. I've been an internet punching bag for the longest time, and being a YouTuber, I'm forced to make daily videos or watch everything I spilled years into fall like a house of cards. I've analyzed how YouTube works, for my channel at least. Missing days of uploading severely F's me over. I get no break. It's an obligation at this point. I virtually see no point in continuing the same repetitious chain of illness, and I really see no point in life anymore. I really don't. On the verge of a mental breakdown, if I'm being truly honest, tired of bottling up shit for months. I could never truly sympathize with others who went through what I have in the past, but now that I've experienced all this in first hand, I can assure you it is draining. Makes you hate and despise life, and I understood fully. And once again, highly considering hanging myself. But I still have fear and regret holding me back. I'm scared of what happens after death, the unknown and the pain. But at this point, I feel like I am too far gone. This shit has been happening too frequently, and it is most likely a sign. Thank you, RTC, to the nice people at least. Thank you to my friends, you know who you are, and people I didn't meet. Also to my boyfriend, if you're reading this, but I can't continue this anymore. Now, here are a few problems with this. One, it's quite obvious he faked it, and there is evidence against him for it. In the past, he tried doing this before, and he failed completely. And he had months to get himself help. He could have called the police. He could have gotten a therapist, which, by the way, he lives in the United Kingdom. Therapists are cheap, and if he calls the suicide helpline, that's completely free with no tax or fee whatsoever. My second point, the reason I know he's lying about his abusive father and domestic abuse and self-harm, stuff like that. It's because he was somehow able to use over $1,000 on Roblox. He had 400,000 Robux. 200,000 Robux is $400. And if you double that, that is $800. In videos in the past, if you put it all together, that's over $1,000, and he has only had his group for about 2 years. And he only gets a couple of hundred Robux in his group every few weeks or so. There is another reason, which I think why he is faking this. One of them being, if he was really going to do this, he would have considered it more carefully, and he would have at least, in person, said bye, or even went to his lover, which he did not, or, well, what we think. Now, if we go back, there are more things which he was using to attention seek. One of them being is that the RTC community is one of the shittiest communities. The pure amount of instant degeneracy, hard mentality, and toxicity are rampant. Bear in mind, he is a person of massive toxicity. He used to be extremely toxic to minority sub-communities like furries, and at one point he was even toxic to LGBT. Breeding ground of pessimism, conflict, and aggression. He himself had participated in the aggression and drama that happened, and he forced himself into it despite having a choice to not. According to him, he's forced to make daily videos, or he is implying that his YouTube channel will die, which is not true at all. Some YouTubers take a month or two to upload one video, and they're able to get hundreds of thousands of views and thousands of subscribers. There are YouTubers who even upload one video a week because of editing and how long the video is, and the fact that they want their content to look good. So he is not forced to make daily videos. That's a complete lie. He has a choice for everything. He made the choice to force himself to make videos every day. I've analysed how YouTube works, for my channel at least. Missing days of uploading severely fucks me over. I get no break. It is an obligation at this point. This is another false point. He's saying that YouTube is the one effing himself over, when in reality, he is the one effing himself over. He is creating videos every day, and they're getting less and less interesting. They're getting less and less longer. They're getting less and less effort. And at this point, it just looks like he was uploading very lazily. The thumbnails are not as good as what they used to be, and the script is boring and is not able to be taken seriously because of how repetitive it is. He's also been known, well, him, Warren, and other YouTubers have been known to milk other people for clout. Parlo especially has been milking Lisa for clout for a long time. Despite Lisa being a pedophile, he does not have any more reason to record about her, as we've already known that she was like this in the past. And it's been about a year or two. And yet again, he continues to upload about her and tweet. Now, he also says that he hates Twitter, and he blames Twitter for himself being an internet punching bag, even though he himself had the choice to get off Twitter, avoid the drama, and completely exit it. That was his choice. He didn't make that choice. He believed that he should be an internet punching bag. That was his choice. He was not forced to stay on Twitter. He could have easily exited Twitter like anyone else. I can exit Twitter, but I choose not to, because I know that I am firm on the stance. Other people are not. I posted it on his Twitter when he said that he was suiciding, that he was just attention seeking. In about less than 10 hours, I have had over 14 replies, all of them having mixed responses. Even Maiko, which, to be fair, he was never really an ally of mine, despite himself implying that he was. Maiko even defended him at one point, despite the proof being against Parlo. There are other people who couldn't agree with me, and they can also give you the proof. Here is more proof. About the money part. How was Parlo able to rack up at least $1,000 worth of Robux if his group had only existed for 2 years, and his streams barely get donations? And he definitely does not have multiple jobs to get that. Where do you think he gets that money from? Does it come out of nowhere? Well, he certainly doesn't get that money from his fans, and he certainly doesn't get it from YouTube. One of PewDiePie's biggest videos has over 60 million views, yet he only got $60 for it. So what makes people think that he's able to get enough money for that? My theory is that he's lying about his family, is that he's living a perfectly normal life, and he's over-exaggerating and painting his family in a bad way. If I'm wrong about this, then I will be making an apology video, and I will be deleting this one. Actually, no, I won't be deleting this one. But if I'm right about this, then I want people to know that I, myself, will always know that someone is faking suicide. I, myself, was suicidal at one point. I was depressed at one point. I was medically diagnosed with depression, and I was also put in a hospital because I was on suicide watch for a week. I was bullied by people, not by kids and teachers at primary school, actually two primary schools. I had to move from one because the bullying got so bad. So I got bullied by teachers and students for years, for about 4 to 6 years. Not only that, the constant hate and harassment online, not from this drama at the moment, but from past dramas, for example, me being a furry, people always like to harass me because of that. And people also harass me because of my own opinions. For example, I do not like the BLM organization. Not the people itself, but the organization, the people who lead it. I do not like some LGBT genders and sexualities. I also do not like what big countries have done. For example, American war crimes, Chinese war crimes, stuff like that. Normal politics. And recently, I've also been getting harassed for having a different roleplay style to someone. And so, this is just my video on an opinion that I made, that I think Parlo is faking the suicide, and he will come back eventually. And I know he's going to come back, because I've seen so many people do this before. He acts the exact same as they do. I will go more into detail about this later, because it's currently almost 10 p.m. and I'm too tired. If you think that you can prove me wrong about this, feel free to join Warren's server or to add me on Discord, as seen on the Main Street channel. If you want to debate me about this or prove me wrong, then feel free to add me and debate me. Other than that, if you have nothing else to say and all you want to do is say I'm wrong, then don't bother. because I doubt this video will ever get into the main stage and no one will care about it that much anyway. Alright, this is Mag. I've done my opinion for 15 minutes and I'm signing off. Good night.